Now to Ryan Widmer's third murder trial tonight, and a key witness took the stand in the Ryan Widmer retrial today.
Once again, Sarah Widmer's mother had to tell jurors what happened the night her only daughter died. News5's Karen Johnson has been covering this case since the beginning. Karen?
Well, Jack, court just wrapped up for the evening after Sarah's mother, Ruth Ann Stewart, took the stand. She talked about the trip she took with Sarah the weekend before Sarah died and about the night she found out her daughter was dead.
Ryan called me. I guess he was in the life squad and the sirens were going off, and I thought he said Sarah fell and needed her mom.
Did you go to the hospital?
I went to the hospital. Mm-hmm.
What did you do when you got there?
I got there and walked in and asked to see Sarah Stewart, and they took me back to her.
What happened when you were taken back?
She was laying there, and I the nurse was nice enough to let me think she was still alive. And so I got to say goodbye to her and talk to her.
And before Sarah's mother took the stand, testimony today focused around the bathtub. All eyes focused on the bathtub as it was carried into the center of the courtroom. This is the jury's first look at the tub in which Sarah Widmer reportedly drowned. Hamilton Township Police Officer Quillen Short showed jurors that there are marks in the tub that appear to be two sets of handprints sliding down the tub.
We are referring to these streaks here, along with the streaks that start on the edge of the top here and come back down.
Short also testified that not only was the bathroom dry the night Sarah drowned, but so were the items found inside the bathroom, clothes, a rug, and this brown towel.
And when you recovered that, or when you first saw it in the evening in question, did you see any indication of moisture anywhere on the towel?
No, sir.
Now, getting back to the testimony that we just heard from Sarah Widmer's mother, she also talked about the heart murmur that Sarah had when she was a baby. That's something that has not been brought up in the two previous trials. You'll hear what she had to say about that coming up tonight at 6. Reporting live in Lebanon, Karen Johnson, News 5.
Once again, for the most complete coverage of the Widmer case, go to our website, WLWT.com. Look under Top Stories. Karen and our online blogger, Travis Geddes, are providing up-to-the-minute news and interactive analysis.